Hello guys, and welcome to this short video to talk about excisional biopsies, okay? Before we proceed, I would like to remind you guys that this video is to orientate and to direct your studies, not to replace all your studies, okay? But this is actually an interesting procedure, so how to perform an excisional biopsy? And before, we need to understand when to perform the excisional biopsy. So this is the procedure that you guys want to perform on small lesions, okay? So up to 1 centimeter, and lesions that look benign, so not malignant lesions, for example. Here we have a lesion, so we have one of my clinical cases, and this is a lesion with a color similar to the mucosa, but then the color is heterogeneous, right? It has a rough appearance, and that's why at that time my clinical diagnosis was first papilloma and then fibroma, okay? So this was the differential diagnosis list that I defined at that time, and then we still don't know if the lesion is pedunculated or not, okay? So how to proceed with this? So first we need the consent of the patient, so you guys will always transfer knowledge to the patient, right? And this is one of the most important things in dentistry, as we always need to make the patient understand and feel comfortable with the procedures that we are offering to them. So after you get the consent of the patient, of course, then we can start with the local anesthesia. So let's see a little bit more about this technique. We start with the local anesthesia, and you guys might want to perform the local anesthesia, of course, close to the base of this lesion, okay? Now you guys are seeing the picture at the left side of your screen that we are throwing some air, and now we can see that the lesion is actually pedunculated, okay? So we are doing our anesthesia, and after this, so what is the next step? And the next step is, of course, the incision to remove the lesion, right? So you guys might want to have your scalpel blade, you know, facing the center of the base of the lesion, and then we need to perform an elliptical tracing, okay, in order to get a wedge-shaped sample. So in other words, you guys will have the lesion, and now we have the scalpel blades, and then we are going to reach the base of the lesion, as you guys are seeing in the picture, and then we want to surround, to contour this lesion, always with the blade facing the center of the lesion, okay? So slightly sideways, for example, and then we perform the elliptical tracing to remove this lesion safely. And of course, we don't need to go too deep because, you know, it's actually a small lesion here. Remember as well that we are talking about the tongue, so we don't have space for the local anesthesia as we have for normal infiltrations that you guys routinely perform to treat root canals, for example, right? So this is something else that we want to remember. And then we can proceed with the removal of the lesion. So now you guys are seeing that we are using a soft tissue forceps to remove the lesion. Okay, and then we need to be careful in order not to damage the lesion, because we are going to send this later to the histological analysis. For this purpose, we want to place this lesion in a plastic container with 10% neutral buffered formalin. And of course, we have blood vessels there. And now we need to control this bleeding. And then we can do this with sutures, or for example, if it's a small lesion like this, then we can use an electrical scalpel like this that you guys are seeing to cauterize the lesion, okay? And that's exactly what we did here. So now after 2 weeks, you guys are seeing, you know, the healing of the lesion, and then, you know, the patient can get back to the normal life without this lesion bothering, and we can have the final diagnosis from the histological analysis, all right? So those were the tips of today, and see you guys in the next videos.